After a day of three long closed-door meetings, the Pope and nine representatives of the Christian churches in Lebanon gathered together to ask God for forgiveness and to pray for peace and stability. They prayed in Arabic, in Armenian, and in Syriac. During the encounter, they recited psalms and read the Beatitudes. Then the Pope invited them to pray the Lord's Prayer, each in his own language.
Padre nostro,
they didn't explain the content of their private meetings, but Pope Francis gave a final speech that likely summed up their conversations. It was an appeal to each person within and outside Lebanon to take responsibility for the situation.
Basta usare il Libano e il Medio Oriente per interessi e profitti stranei. Occorre dare ai libanesi la possibilità di essere protagonisti di un futuro migliore nella loro terra e senza indebite interferenze.
The Pope and other Christian leaders present fear the collapse of Lebanon, which is the only country in the Middle East where Christians aren't a small minority. That's why Pope Francis said that those gathered made a commitment to collaborate, not nursing past grudges, nor shirking the responsibilities of the present.
Come cristiani, oggi vogliamo rinnovare il nostro impegno a edificare un futuro insieme, perché l'avvenire sarà pacifico solo se sarà comune. Assicuriamo perciò ai fratelli e alle sorelle musulmani e di altre religioni apertura, disponibilità a collaborare per edificare la fraternità e promuovere la pace.
Each of the representatives, among them in evangelical, but also Orthodox and Armenian Christians, received a lit candle from a young person from Lebanon. Before bidding them farewell, the Pope asked them to keep the future of these young people in mind, and to remember the tears of the country's children when making decisions for their people.